two natural lakes in Virginia, and everything else is man-made. And so there are hundreds to probably thousands of larger lakes in Virginia, and then thousands to maybe a 10,000 of these little stormwater ponds in Virginia. And this isn't the way water historically has been in Virginia. Water has flowed across the landscape, but now we are impounding it in these reservoirs, stormwater ponds, and so forth. And as organic matter collects in these ponds, then we're creating situations where there's a lot more opportunity for anaerobic processes to lead to methane and nitrous oxide release, more greenhouse gas getting into the atmosphere because of all of these ponds on the landscape.
So last year, Professor Chambers did research on the outward flux of three greenhouse gases on different stormwater retention ponds across Game City County. And this year he was interested in finding out the difference that a bubbler or sprinkler makes in a pond. So we are testing on Grimdell, and Swemdell on campus here. And we are testing when the pond aerators are on versus off and seeing if there's a major difference between the outward flux of methane, carbon dioxide, and nitrous oxide coming out of the ponds.
And then put in the sample and press it. Right now we're measuring the concentrations of gases collected from the various ponds on campus. Well, I mean, I'd heard about them putting in the fountain in the lake and then seeing if that would increase or decrease the amount of greenhouse gases coming from all the ponds, and trying to figure out if that has a positive effect could make our impact as a school less, at least on our local kind of footprint.
If the fountains are not effectively oxidizing the methane prior to its diffusion to the atmosphere, then they ought to modify the way these fountains are structured so that they are pulling water from deeper in the pond, oxidating that water, and then enhancing the oxidation of methane prior to diffusion out of the pond.